Hi everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to configure the React File Upload component using the Create React App command and the Syncfusion EJ2 React Inputs package. Using the React File Upload component, you can upload images, documents, and other files. Just browse and select the files you want to upload. The selected files will be uploaded to the server at the click of a button. If you click the clear button, the selected or uploaded files will be cleared from the list. In this video, I will show you how to configure a few of this component's basic features, like uploading a single file or multiple files at a time, validating files before uploading, and saving and removing files in the uploader using APIs. Let's start with the application creation process. Make sure you have installed the latest versions of React and Node in your system. I'll use VS Code as my editor and show the output in the Chrome browser. First, I create a new application in the command prompt using the npx create react app command and provide the app name, my React app. I want to create a React app with TypeScript, so let me add template TypeScript. It will take a few seconds to create the project. Second, I navigate to the project location. And to use the uploader component, I install the Syncfusion React Inputs package using the npm install at Syncfusion EJ2 React Inputs. Let's wait for the package to install. Third, I open the project in VS Code. Before using the Syncfusion components, I need to register the trial license key. I open the index.tsx file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key from the 2022 Volume 1 release onwards. The license key is mandatory for React components to avoid license warnings. To see where to generate a trial license key, check the description below. Next, I open the app.css file and replace the default styles with the Syncfusion Material CSS styles required for the file upload component. After that, I open the app.tsx file and remove the default code snippets. To start using the component, I import the uploader component from the Syncfusion EJ2 React Inputs package. And include the uploader component tag. Let me run this application using the command npm start. It has two options to upload a file using the browse button or dropping files here directly. Notice here, you can see the status ready to upload, and you can remove any file from this list. Next, I will show you how to enable asynchronous uploading. To do that, I need to specify the save and remove URLs in an async settings property. So, I declare a variable path and assign the save and remove URLs. These service URLs are hosted on the server that contains the upload box controller with save and remove APIs. Then I assign this variable to the async settings property. Let me show you the save and remove server-side APIs. In the upload box controller, you can find a save method where all the files are processed one by one using the if condition. Here, I retrieve the file name from the HTTP context, check whether that file exists in the provided path, and create the file using the save as method. In the remove method, I retrieve the file name from the HTTP context, and then remove the file if it exists in the provided location using the delete method. Checking now, when I browse and select a file, it will be uploaded. If I click the Delete File button in the upload list, the file will be deleted. By default, you can select multiple files and upload them simultaneously. To restrict uploads to a single file, you must disable the multiple property. Checking now, I can select only one file and upload it. Even when I drag multiple files, only the topmost file will be uploaded. I'll enable this property to explain upcoming features. To manually upload the files, disable the auto-upload property. Look now, as soon as you select a file, you'll find two action buttons, upload and clear. You can remove any unwanted files and upload the remaining files using these buttons. If you want to upload files one by one in a specific order, then enable the sequential upload property. Also, I'll enable the auto-upload property. Just browse and select the files you want to upload. And now we can see the files are uploaded one after the other. Next, I will show you how to perform chunk upload to prevent timing out issues with large files. I just include the chunk size property in the async settings and set its value to 102,400 bytes. Checking now, when I browse and select a file, the file uploader breaks large files into smaller chunks based on the provided size and uploads the chunks individually. You can pause and resume the upload or abort it. To upload an entire directory or folder of files at once, I enable the directory upload property. Now I can select a folder and all the files in the folder will be updated in the upload list. Next, I will show you how to upload specific file types. Include the allowed extensions property and assign the file type PDF. And I disabled the directory uploading. And now, when I browse, only PDF files are shown to select. When I drop Excel files, I get the error message, file type is not allowed. Finally, I'll show you how to validate the files before uploading them to the server. By default, the file upload component allows you to upload a minimum file size of 0 bytes and a maximum file size of 28 megabytes. I can prevent uploading large files by using the min file size and max file size properties. Set the min file size to 10 kilobytes, which is 10,000 bytes, and the max file size to 100 kilobytes. That is 100,000 bytes. See, I cannot upload a larger file. I receive a file size is too large error. And files within the specified size get uploaded. In this video, I have shown you how to create and configure the Syncfusion React File Upload component using the Create React App command, and how to use a few of its basic features. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also shared a link where you can learn about obtaining a free license key to use our React products if you're eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.